Buenos días, ¿cómo están todos? How's everyone feeling? This is a great dynamic group. You can tell my coffee kicked in. So, as your first Latina Lieutenant Governor, not only in the state of Illinois, but in the whole country, I wanted to be here today to welcome each and every one of you to this very important conference on behalf of not only myself, your Lieutenant Governor, but Governor Bruce Rauner. Welcome, because you guys are gonna have a great time interfacing with other agencies, talking with them and everything. So a big show of hands, because you guys are gonna learn a lot, right? But I also not only want to welcome everyone to this 31st annual event, but there are a few particular thank yous I want to give from the stage today. I want to thank Carlos Charmeco, who's a big fighter and always inviting me to events so that I could get the word out on what the state is doing to be more diverse, more inclusive each and every day. Gracias a Iván Barajas, José López también, for all the work that you do, as well as this organization that has been advocating for Latino state employees for the past 31 years. That's a big deal, folks. I'd also like to thank and recognize the fine work of Lisa Williams, CMS Deputy Director of Diversity and Inclusion. Thank you so much, Lisa, because she is responsible for assisting state agencies with development and implementation of diversity programs. Her focus on supervisory, technical, professional, and managerial levels. So, I'm proud to tell you that our administration, each and every day, continues to improve on the development of its diversity pool. I'm happy to report that Latino representation among state employees has grown more than 5%, which is significant because you folks know that it's a lot of work. Having that dual language is a big deal. And from a personal standpoint, I want to tell you what a big deal it is to have that dual language. A lot of people don't know, si soy mitad cubana, my mom, a refugee from Fidel Castro's Cuba, and my dad, de Guadalupe. Both families immigrated to Hialeah, which is where I was born. So growing up with immigrant and refugee families, you know that the first language that you speak is not English, right? The first language that you speak out of respect to your elders in the home, and I want to tell you that growing up in a household like this, I want to tell you how difficult it was, because my parents, being refugees and immigrants, did not command the language, and so they needed instruction each and every day as far as how to navigate in the state and be able to get the services that they need. And I think each and every one of you appreciate how difficult it is for those families that don't command the English language to be able to avail themselves of the sort of services that each and every one of you provides. And that's significant. So as a child, growing up in that sort of atmosphere, I became what a lot of you became in your households growing up, that child advocate, right? I see a yes in the front row. Right? You open up the mail for your parents and you say, Mommy, el alquiler es due, the rent is due. Mommy, this piece of mail means that you should go to the doctor because your physical is up and coming. And you know the pressures that these child advocates feel, right? Because on top of having to learn the English language, you also have the pressure of being able to have your family show up to these medical appointments, show up to get the services that they need. And we shouldn't give that responsibility to the children in Hispanic households. That responsibility has to lie with all of us as state actors. And this is why it's so very important to have a diverse pool within our makeup in state employment. I see it here, but I know it needs to grow. It needs to grow so that we could continue to provide services to the people that need it the most in the state of Illinois. There's no question that Latinos are the largest growing minority population right now. And statistics show that in a few short years, we shall be the majority. And so if that is the case, we need to have more diversity within our state agencies to provide for this sort of makeup. So in other words, our agencies and the state of Illinois needs to be a mirror image of what is out there. And so it needs to start in each and every agency. It also needs to start with my office, right? Because I know you guys are thinking, okay, you're pointing at me. What are you doing in the office of the Lieutenant Governor? Well, I'm very proud to say that in our office of La Vice Gobernadora, we are 50% Hispanic, completely fluent, completely able to travel the state, go to Arcola, go to Ornarga, go to Carbondale to provide for the makeup that is our general population in the state of Illinois. So each and every day we should continue to provide so that we can lift that burden from those families where those children feel that they have to lift the burden for their whole family because they don't understand the language to avail themselves of the sort of services that we offer. Is that not the case? ¿No es verdad? Que sí, que sí. Así que let's keep working. Thank you all so much. And enjoy the conference. Esto se va a poner caliente, así que hace falta traer más café. Thank you so much.
And it's a privilege for me to open up our 31st annual training conference. Thank you guys for participating in all the agencies that allow our employees to come out. At this point, I'd like to welcome the Illinois Department of Corrections Honor Guard to present the colors.
I'll have to shorten that bio a bit. I really appreciate the opportunity to speak with you this afternoon. In Illinois, we've gained. Latinos have gained over the last 31 years. We've gained strength primarily because of the growth of the population, which has led to increased Latino representation, increased political influence, and we're today 17.3% of the population. And that's an undercount. Again, those are census figures. Because we gained political representation in the 80s at the state level, we were able to create IACE. IACE's accomplishments, for those of you who've been around for a while, you know what those accomplishments are. And those accomplishments were due primarily to the partnership that IACE had with Latino legislators and other legislators with Latino populations within their districts. The Latino Caucus was created 6 years, many years, after IACE was created. I helped create IACE in my first year, my freshman year as a state senator. And the Latino Caucus wasn't created until 5 years after that. But it was important that the Latino Caucus and IACE work as one in the General Assembly. And it was during that period, during those times when there was that collaboration and ongoing communication, that a lot of things happened, like the legislating of a number of actions that led to the creation of the annual Hispanic Employment Program. I was the sponsor of the bill to create bilingual pay. I knew that that would be the first hand I got. I knew it. That's why I saved it. Okay, because I'm not a joke teller. But I knew that I would get a hand in the chuckle. But bilingual pay, there's an annual report on bilingual pay. I'll touch on that in just a second. Training, opportunities for operability, leadership, lobby days, influencing the shape, the public policy that is generated by the General Assembly, and advocacy. But in spite of the progress, we have not yet achieved parity. You have that report. You have those numbers in front of you. I am dissatisfied, to put it mildly. I don't want to use another word, but I am dissatisfied with these numbers. 31 years later, Latinos make up every legislator, Latino legislator who didn't show up today should get phone calls from all of you and ask them why. And if they had valid excuses for not being here today, then say, when will you meet with us? And send delegations of IASE to spell things out and to lay out a work plan. We all know what to do. We know what needs to be done. We've had success in the past. We can have success in the future if we all come together. There is a better day on the horizon. I know that. If we all come together. Thank you.
Miguel, we need you.